Boulder Road, just off Route 9. It fades into the lake at the low water line. Sometimes I wander down that road alone, remembering the town that I once called home. I grew up in the valley, every neighbor a friend, until the modern world started creeping in. One day came the lawyers with cash in hand. They swore that our village would light up the land. The dusky waters move cold and slow, and the ghosts of the village still wander below. Homesteads of families and friends forevermore, haunting the valley below this sparkling shore. Surrounding the valley was a painted red line, drawn by company men, like marking a crime. A silent reminder that all inside it must go, or be lost to the rising dead river's flow. Some folks took the money, started grinding gears, while the rest of us held out for 20 odd years. We watched our town like a photograph fade, as the company came to take it all away. They tore down the church and the schoolhouse burned. They dug up the graves, the wheels of progress turned. They got Dutchie's store and Haven's pool hall. Dozers rolled, it shattered us all. The dusky waters move cold and slow, and the ghosts of the village still wander below. Homesteads of families and friends forevermore, haunting the valley below this sparkling shore. Savage stayed as long as she could. Her house on the hill towered over the flood. It rose up alone in the dark of night, its face on the water and the cold moonlight. I shake off the memories, on my lips a prayer. Place for the grace and the beauty down there. And while the porch lights glow all over the state, there's nothing but darkness under the lake. The dusky waters move cold and slow, and the ghosts of a village still wander below. Homesteads of families and friends forevermore, haunting the valley below this sparkling shore. They haunt the valley below this sparkling shore.